Hi, my name is Franco Rotoli from the SOLIDWORKS training team. In this bonus video, I'll be taking you on a quick tour of the 3D Experience platform as a new user. I'll show you how to navigate through the default dashboard, find your collaborative spaces, create and manage bookmarks, and find communities so you can collaborate and share with your team. You'll see how it all fits together in one place so you'll have access to everything you need right at your fingertips. Let's get started. As a new user, the first thing you'll receive is an email that looks like this. Don't ignore this email. This has a link to your specific 3D Experience tenant or workspace. You'll probably want to bookmark this link in your browser for faster access later on. The link will bring you to the 3D Experience login screen. If you already have an ID, you can log in. Or if you don't, you can create one here. I'll log in with my credentials. Once logged in, we're presented with a dashboard. Think of this as a customizable desktop for your 3D Experience apps and widgets. By clicking the hamburger or three-line icon on the left, a flyout shows us all the dashboards and cockpits we have access to. Dashboards are fully customizable and you can start from a blank slate. Cockpits are tailored to your roles and pre-designed for you. Right now, we're looking at the 3D Creator Home cockpit. I'll close the pane by clicking the X to give us more room. You can make any widget full screen by clicking this icon on the widget. The welcome widget has four columns. The first one is focused on design apps, data management, and collaboration. The second column is the Learning Center. Here you can find a bunch of videos to help you learn all about the 3D Experience and its apps. Click on View All to see many more. The third column is all about social interaction. Here you can find communities of like-minded people sharing information and ideas. Finally, the fourth column has some sample content. You can start by opening these sample files and see how they were created. To exit full screen mode, I'll click this button. Another part of your dashboard is the tabs section at the top. Think of these as tabs on your browser. The content tab gives you access to all your private, secure data that's stored on the platform. Collaborative spaces are like huge warehouses of data you have access to. Your admin assigns rights as to who can create these. Bookmarks are like shortcuts to specific data within the collaborative spaces. You can create your own bookmarks, and it can resemble a Windows folder structure that we're all used to, with bookmarks being folders and subfolders. To add a bookmark, click this button. I'll create a new top-level bookmark named YouTube. By clicking the Show More button, you can add a description as well. I'll double-click the bookmark to enter it like a folder, and I can add another bookmark here. On the left, we see that it's starting to resemble a folder structure, so I can organize my data. In my training bookmark, I have a model of an automotive jack. If I drag this file to the 3D Play app, it'll open a 3D preview of it, where I can zoom, pan, rotate, and more. To close this preview, simply click the X. The Tasks tab works like a Kanban board. You can add tasks, track their progress, and share with your teammates. The Communities tab gives you access to the 3D Swim communities. Here, you can collaborate with other users, designers, and makers. A very popular public community is the SOLIDWORKS User Forum. Communities can be public, private, or by invitation only to keep your information secure. Going back to the Design tab, I'll make XDesign full screen and can start designing right away. Thanks for watching. Again, click the link below to access other videos in this playlist, Beginner's Guide to XDesign. And as always, happy modeling.